Ever since Windows 10 was released back in 2015, Microsoft has had it on a semi-annual update schedule where they would release a major feature update every spring and fall, typically. But apparently that's going to be changing this fall, which is terrible news for me because all my major Windows update videos always do really well. But for everyone else, including you, that's probably a good thing that they're changing this schedule, and we're gonna go over how they're changing it and why it's good, I think. So how do we know that Microsoft is very likely gonna be changing the update schedule for Windows 10? And the answer is that they've already changed how they released Windows Insider preview builds to insiders. Now, if you didn't know, the Windows Insider program is basically just like you can sign up to receive beta builds for Windows, and then you kind of can give bug feedback and that sort of thing. You're kind of like a beta tester. I would not recommend that for your main build, obviously, because it can be very buggy. That's another story. But up until recently, how it worked was there were two different speeds for release in this insider build. There was the fast ring and the slow ring. And what would happen is the fast ring would get the major update that usually is every 6 months, they would get that 6 months early. So the one that would be in the fall, they'd get it in the spring. And then after all the initial really big bugs and stuff would work out, after about 3 months in the summer, then the slow ring would get the update like 3 months early before the final release. And then the final release would be that fall. But this time around, the Insider Fast Ring got an update that was a full year in advance. And this is codenamed 20H1, so 2020 half one. And the slow ring actually got an update in the summer that is only a minor update that is scheduled for the fall of this year. So the fast ring is getting this major update that's a year ahead of time and completely skipping this minor update that's gonna be in the fall, while the slow ring got this minor update that's gonna be released in the fall, and it's codenamed 19H2, so the second half of 2019. Now, I had heard rumors that Microsoft was going to be changing their semi-annual twice-a-year update schedule for Windows 10 for a while now, and it does seem like with this implementation of this new release schedule for the insiders that is likely going to happen. So what's likely going to happen, it seems like, is that there's going to be every 6 months there's still going to be an update, but one of them in the spring is going to be the major one, and then the one in the fall is going to be the minor feature update. And then of course, as usual, there's going to be security patches spread throughout the year, and there's not going to be any delays on the security patches, of course. Now, I do think that this would be a much better schedule. I think it seems like twice a year might be too fast for Microsoft. I mean, every time there's a major update, it seems like there's something that goes wrong. I mean, there was that catastrophe with some folders being completely deleted by the Windows update. I mean, that was like the worst I've ever heard of. And then there's all these other bugs, like I've installed updates where it would break Steam, it would break certain programs I was using, like Adobe or like Camtasia screen recorder. Something would always break, and that's why I do not update the major updates right away. I have my computer on like a 60-day delay every time, and I still have not installed the 2019 May update on my main computer yet because of this. I'm thinking, you know, it might break something. I don't really have any features that I absolutely need, so I'm not gonna bother yet. And I do think that this will allow a lot more bugs to be worked out. If they're not releasing them so quickly, they'll have a little bit more time to work on the bugs and think things through. And I don't know how this is gonna come into play with the minor updates, whether they're gonna be still feature updates, just not as big ones, or maybe the minor update will be like patches on the big one. I don't know, hopefully they'll have that sorted out earlier than having to wait 6 months for the patches, but still. Though I do wonder how this is going to affect Microsoft's overall master plan of basically turning Windows into a service. They've kind of been doing this since the beginning of Windows 10. I believe that was the original plan, was to make it so instead of releasing, you know, a major version of Windows every 5 years or so, they would just kind of continuously improve it. And I think that still could be on track with this new major update once a year and then a minor update every 6 months. But it does seem like this is gonna be more like their traditional service pack update schedule that they had before Windows 10. Like with Windows 7, there was like a couple service packs for each one. And if it does have a 5-year shelf life in the first place for the previous versions, then you know, every year is not so far off every 2 years. So it's almost kind of like they're just going back to what they were doing before. So maybe they'll have just a couple major features, and then they'll still have a good number of features, but still kind of call it a minor update. And I also think the whole difference between a major and minor update has to do with how long it takes to install and the complications involved in installing. Because as you know, when you install one of the major updates, it typically requires you to spend more time restarting it and it takes longer to install. Whereas I believe these minor updates are gonna be more like a quick install that you don't even really notice. So we'll have to see how that plays out. Of course, I am a bit concerned that even if they do have more time to spend on these updates, are they gonna even use that extra time to properly get all the bugs out? Or is it just gonna be even worse every year where they don't properly bug fix everything? And then you'll end up just having twice as many bugs that are twice as big because they compressed releasing them all at once. I don't know, hopefully that's not the case, but you never know with Microsoft. In any case, I just wanted to give you guys this update. So in the next couple months, if you see, hey, I wonder if the next big Windows update is gonna have anything cool, then you might be having to wait a little bit longer. And of course, I'll probably still make updates on Windows every 6 months in the case that they release some stuff that's pretty cool. Even if it's not a major update, if it's still worth talking about, I'll still make a video about it. So let me know what you think of this. Do Windows updates usually break your computer? Do they usually work fine with no problems? I'd be interested to hear what you guys think down in the comments. If you wanna keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here you can just click on. I make a couple new videos a week, so it should be worth it to subscribe. So thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.